Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Ordinary Data Scientist, where we talk about data science. Now let's talk about data type. Another, I would say, a good topic is the data type. Now if you had come across data generated through marketing campaign and all, you might have seen various kind of data, right? So the data today we will discuss are mostly two types. One is called qualitative and another is called quantitative, right? There are mostly two kind of data, qualitative and quantitative. Now if you understand that whenever we talk about qualitative of the data, means it gives the characteristic of the data, right? Or quality of the data, isn't it? And when we talk about the quantity, it gives some of the size or something, you know. So you generally understand this seems like a more mathematical, while it seems more like categorical kind of variable, right? So I'm just writing it down, categorical, and it's more like mathematical. Now think about examples. I write one statement, okay? Let's say my score is better than yours, or product A has 5 stars rating, whereas product B has 3 stars. Now I have written these two statements. What do you understand? My score is better than yours, you know, means score here is what I'm measuring, is the score, and I'm saying mine is better, so it's a qualitative data. Similarly, product A has 5 stars, you know, rating, where the product B has 3 stars. So you are measuring the characteristic of some product A and product B, using some characteristic. So these are the example of your qualitative data, right? Similarly, quantitative, when I say quantitative, if I write another statement, similarly, if I write another statement that product A sales is equal to 5,000, and similarly, product B sales is equal to 10,000, you can see that the product B has sold more than product A. This is qualitative, okay? So that's why you have to understand the difference between qualitative and quantitative. I'll say that take a pause here, think about some random examples like this, and try to relate that the KPI that we are measuring there, is it qualitative or is it quantitative, okay? So let me scroll down and bring your attention to here. So as of now, we just talk about the quantitative and qualitative data. For quantitative, as I said, gives you the measurement in terms of their size, will be numerical, as I said, right? While qualitative is a non-numeric, right? It's a categorical, like yes, no. Now let's talk about other kind of data. Now here we had qualitative, and here we have quantitative, okay? Now the data that we generally have in our day-to-day life can be divided into four different types, right? Or if you go through this chart, there can be different types, but I'll mostly talk about these four types, okay? The first type that we should talk about is nominal data. Now let me put it here, then we will decide where it should go, okay? Nominal. The second is ordinal, third is your interval, and fourth is your ratio. Okay, so these are the four kind of data that I have. I'll give one example and definition, and then we will think that where it should go, okay? Nominal data. So nominal data is generally the kind of data that you see in surveys. For example, when you start a survey, it asks you, are you a male or female? Or else, something else, right? So it will give you select A, B, or if you want to select others, it's C, right? Something like that. It will definitely ask you like that, A, B, C. Similarly, it might ask you to select the city, where do you stay? So city, you know, you need to select Bangalore, Bombay, Delhi, or something like that. Again, it's a data, right? It's a data point. Based on that, I can make some information about you. If you select B, I will say that, yeah, it's a female, lives in Bangalore, age group is this and that and all. So it's a data point, right? But this shows the characteristic of the person. It doesn't measure anything in a numeric manner, in a number format, right? It just gives the information. So A, B, C, the data point that I collect, can very much be 1, 2, 3 also. Like option 1 is male, option 2 is female, option 3 is others. It can happen, right? So, you know, it can take any kind of numbers. And also the difference between them doesn't make sense. I can't say that, okay, female is 2, that means female is greater than male, or C is greater than 2, 1. No, there is no mathematical relation between 1 and 2 and 3, right? It's just a representation of that KPI or of that person, whatever, okay? So it's a nominal data. Now, if you think nominal data is kind of showing the quality of the person or quality of the respondent, so should go to qualitative. Okay, nominal data. Now, ordinal data. Now, ordinal data will have all the characteristics from nominal plus something else. What is something else? I'll show you. So, let's say you have one example. Let's say you want to rate a product out of 5. So let's say a product is anything. Let's say your mobile phone, you know, and you need to rate it out of 5. So this is 1 star, 2 star, 3 star, 4 star, and 5 star, like something like that. If you select 2, it will be 2 star. If you select, you know, 3, 4, whatever, 4 star and all. So you see, the gap now started making sense. You know, if it is 2 star or 4 star, that means there is a gap of 2, isn't it, right? So they it can be in the same sequence like we had for nominal, but the difference will start making sense. Yeah, you know? So for example, I gave example of ratings ABCD. Similarly, I give example of ratings 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Similarly, it can be also your educations. For example, if you have, education. Let's say if you are higher studies is PhD, you will select 4. If it is master, you will select this option, you know? And if it is bachelor, you select this. And if you have something else, you select this. So 1, 4. If you select 4 and someone selected 1, that means there is a difference of education level. You know, I can literally find that, yeah, the person who selected 1 might be lesser educated, let's say 10 or whatever, but the person who selected 4 is definitely very much educated, PhD now. Okay? So that now the difference started making sense, while in nominal it didn't make sense. Now if you think ordinal is, again, doesn't give you any numeric information, like bachelor, PhD, doesn't give you any numeric information, right? So that's why it shows the characteristic of the person. Yeah, he's very much educated, well educated, it is a good product or not good product. So again, ordinal will go to qualitative data. Okay, so qualitative data is ordinal. I'll rough it. Now the remaining two, interval and ratio, let's understand them now. Interval. Now you might have this kind of thing that someone might ask you that, hey, when will you reach, right? Your friend A says, hey, I'll reach by 2 p.m. Your friend B says, hey, I'll reach by 4 p.m. And another person C says that I'll reach by 5 p.m. Now, you see everything is in series, yeah? And the difference also makes sense, right? That, okay, this person will come 2 hours later than person A, and person C will come almost 1 hour, you know, after B, or probably 3 hours after A, you know, something like that. So you see the difference also started making sense, and also it is a numeric number like 2, 4, 5 and all. Yeah. So this is called interval data. Before jumping to some other example, let's quickly understand ratio also. So this is interval. Now let's understand ratio. What is ratio data? Now ratio data will have same characteristic of interval, and then on top of that it will have some other data also. Okay, so ratio data, if you think, let's say your just example, your what is your height? So you will say, hey, my height is, I'm just making it up, 10 meters person A. Person B might say that, hey, my height is 20 meters. And person C might say that, hey, my height is 30 meters. You see, the difference makes sense that, yeah, 10 by 10, 20, he's 10 meters taller than A. This person is 10 meters taller than B and probably 20 meters taller than A. The difference makes sense. And also the ratio makes sense. 10 by 20, 10 by 30, 20 by 30 and all, if I write that. So person C is 3 times taller than A, person B is 2 times taller than A, and so on and so forth, right? The ratio is making sense. So this is called ratio data. And ratio will have absolute zero, where the interval will not have an absolute zero. It will have absolute zero. Here, interval, you will have a reference point, and from there you will start measuring anything. Okay, so here you definitely need a reference point, and here it's absolute zero. So that's the difference between two, three difference between interval and ratio. And now, as we see, interval and ratio has numeric number from on which we can do some kind of calculation, right? Okay, these are the different kind of data types that we just saw, and these are the different kind of analysis that we can perform using the data. Okay, for example, if you see mean, median, mode, we can calculate everything for ratio kind of data. As I said, it's at absolute zero, see, but for other we cannot calculate. So I'll request that please pause the video here, think about this chart, and think that why is it possible or why is it not possible. I'll just give you a challenge that can we calculate the mean of ordinal data. You know, I'll just give this challenge to you. Think about this, you know, if we can, how, and you know why it says no here, you know, by theory, and where you have seen examples also. I'll just give an idea, like if you go to Amazon and check any product, it will say 4.2 ratings and all. Think that why, you know, we cannot calculate the mean of ordinal data, whereas we generally see, you know, those kind of numbers or those kind of information in our day-to-day life. Okay, I'll let you do that. Another example of different kind of data set, please go through them also. Okay, let's take the example of pizza delivery and then we'll try to wrap it up. You know, so this is a very big company, De Janeiro Pizza. They wanted to launch a new product in the market, you know, but before launching they wanted to understand what are the characteristics that customer need, which are not currently getting fulfilled, and where is the potential to grab new customer base. Okay, so probably before looking at the solution, take a pause here, just read the problem statement and think what exactly you would have done when, you know, if this challenge comes to you, right? I'll just quickly give some idea, and then probably when you try to solve this problem, you should come across these pointers, but please hide these pointers, you know, think yourself and then try to think that where is the gap, you know, did you try to cover all the grounds, did you try to think like a VP, or is there anything you did miss. Okay, so people, this was the about introduction to the statistics. In next chapter, we'll talk about some of the graph charts and where exactly we need, you know, those graph charts and why. But again, I'll request that go through the notes, try to understand the key concepts before jumping to the next chapter. If you had watched the video so far, please give a thumbs up, share your comments, suggestion, feedback, so that I can improve myself. But please do practice, read more articles, watch other videos if you couldn't grab something from this video. With that, I'll take a pause here and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.